Monday morning, April the 30th. We are here on the Treasure Coast Southern for a very special workshop. We've completed an airbrush class on Saturday, and now we're going to try out our skills. So hang around. We're going to have some fun. We are back on the paint shop workshop. I've got flow quills all here. I mixed up, whipped up the paint that I wanted. We are using testers. We are using flow quill. We've got cans of Badger for Propel, backup, backing us up. We've got feldspar. Rick is using feldspar. Rick likes feldspar. And right now, we are looking over Bob Garland's shoulder. Bob's got the airbrush going. I've just completed three cars, and I'll take you over and show them. They're in the drying rack. We have set up a very small little compressor on the ground. We've got different bottles of cleaning solutions. We've got rubbing alcohol. We've got paintbrush cleaner.
Now stay away from it.
And we got bags full of the cardboard cores from paper towels. The paper towel cores are ideal for workshop holders because they slip right over a skewer, and we give Bob a chance to spray on the UPS truck. He's going to spray a primer coat, a white primer. We'll let him work on that, and we'll watch his progress. I'm going to shut off here and walk over to the drying shop. I'll show you in just a second. To let the models dry off, we've left them on their carton tubes, and we've put them inside the van where they're out of the wind. Won't collect any dust. I'm going to just flip that around and come back here and show you my handiwork. I've got three hoppers, three riveted hoppers, four bay and a two bay. The narrow little car had C&O printing all over it. Take that out in the sunlight in just a couple minutes. Let that dry up, and we'll be back. Little compressor is going like crazy for us. Follow right up the air hose. We're using that tiny little 1/8-inch size hose. Bob very gently spraying on primer onto what is a UPS, HO size UPS, brown guy's truck. The primer, of course. Say it again, Bob.
This is going to be a white truck.
A white guy's truck. Okay, the white primer, of course, is necessary because without it, we will not get the shiny top coat. So we're going to load them up. Rick's whipped up another batch of paint. The first batch was very thin. This is thicker. The cup is full. Let him turn loose and go for it.
Well, remember, this is just primer, so we can mask it for other things and put little black dots or something like that on it. Maggie!
Yeah, it's going to need primer on this yellow dots and all that.
Bob, as long as it doesn't come up wet looking, you're fine.
That's too much stuff on it. Yeah. Well, a little bit slower on it. He's starting to... If it looks
shiny wet, we've got too much. So flip it around. Flip it around to the other side. That's great. Good. Keep twisting. Our little outdoor workshop consists of a spray booth made out of a carton box.
Cranberry box.
The styrofoam block holds up skewers. We can very simply put the carton tubes over the skewers and take a break. To hold the paintbrush up, airbrush, we've cut notches in the corner of the box. Simply let it sit right there. Take a little break here and we'll charge up. We are back on the workshop. We've got a second compressor in service right now. They are both about the same size, two different models. We are letting Bob test drive. Bob's got a caboose. wind has really come up and he's having to take a break every time there's a gust. So he's painting between the numbers. We'll look right over the shoulder and show you a small wooden frame bobber caboose. Coming along good. I'm going to give a spritz, a light coat of primer, and then twist end by end. Okay. Another shot of paint, another little cup. We are using medicine vials, old medicine vials, to whip up because they are disposable. He's got a cup full of paint. The paint does go fast once you really get into it. So, very light with the thumb, got air flowing through, and then pull back on the trigger, and we're applying that white primer, little by little. We'll watch this project, we'll watch how it turns from black plastic to shiny white primer. Give you a look at the little caboose. It's going to be a little white caboose as he's finishing up.
Yeah, you got a little bit left here. I'm gonna make a bunch. Okay.
Bob's been working all these months with a paintbrush and now with an airbrush. We'll compare the results. We'll see how we like them. The cleanup has always frightened me. I always thought that was an awful chore, but it doesn't seem too bad if you use the right materials. We'll go over to the drying booth in just a second and we'll take a look, see how we're doing there. In the background, Rick is using a can of spray paint, spray primer. It was on sale, translates into cheapo cheapo. And he's taking the shiny black plastic car, giving it a good shot of primer. Primer is important for us. That is shiny plastic.
The one thing, this is the one we're using to spray the paint in there.
Hold it up.
This is Valspar's primer.
Okay.
But the same thing we're using in the airbrush right now, but unfortunately there's so much paint from trying to dump it in the thing, I'm getting spots.
Ah, okay.
So, I guess the moral of that is don't use the same one you're trying to empty from.
When we took it out in the sunlight and took a look, Bob was able to see that the top of the hood over the motor needed an extra coat.
Yeah.
So we've
we've
turned that over because that's the part that everybody sees first. Let me turn the. We are still on the paint shop. Bob has his bobber caboose inside the paint booth, and also UPS, the brown guys. Bob's still painting the spray painting the white primer. Very, very light coat at a time. The idea being not to obscure any details. And give it a light misting, let it dry, and then come back with some more. We're learning as we go. We're back on the paint shop project one more time. Rick is going to try his hand. This will be the third color today. We've had boxcar brown, primer white, and now, Rick's favorite gold color, going on this hack. The FEC is cranked up on Monday morning, no less, over our shoulder, with us leaning in on the scanner. And we're watching as Rick applies the first of the gold color, Sunburst.
Yeah.
And he's covering up all the primered white. The roof will stay in white primer, so he's specifically trying not to hit that. And you watch Rick's technique. He's going wherever he thinks. Now he's brave enough. Still listening to dispatch. He's brave enough to go up and down. Neither Bob and I tried up or down. We just tried back and forth. We're we'll give him a chance to lay some of that on there. We'll come back and check after that. The paint shop special today has been successful. There are three hoppers, one reefer, two caboose cars. All got shot. Bob Gollings has, and I'm going to walk over and show you that in a second here. Bob Gollings has transformed a brown guy's UPS truck into Robert's air conditioning. We've had a lot of fun playing around, practicing with the airbrush, learning how to make sure it's clean, finding out our different air supplies. We did not try Badger Propel. We did find that alcohol did not work, but brush cleaning fluid did a good job. An indispensable item are all these paper towels. We'll need them. And the cardboard carton tubes from paper towels. It's a great way to hold things up, too. We've had a good day today. Glad you've been looking over our shoulder. One last look around the railway. Nothing, no wheel is turned today, which is okay with us because maintenance was our priority. We will be back on Wednesday. Join us Wednesday morning for a workshop. The workshop guys will be working on buildings. We'll be laying track. And don't forget, we'll be back here on the paint shop. A few more hopper cars, see how they turn out. Play with those airbrush tools. Thanks for joining us.